Welcome back everybody to Boats vs. Holover, where man and machine take on Mother Nature down at Holover Inlet, Miami, Florida. But today we are on a field trip and we're over at Boca Inlet. And here we can see this Nortec running its way through the inlet. Looks like it'll be a fun day for the boats. Be interesting to see who wins this competition today. Let's get it started. Our first boat to do battle with Boca Inlet is going to show us those little whalers are at it again. These little whalers seem to come through Holover and rip it up. Let's see how they fare down here at Boca. Here they're going to come rolling through at a pretty good pace and actually look pretty solid, especially for it being such a rough day and only being a 17-foot boat. I'll tell you what, I'm always really surprised with these boats when they come through the inlet. It doesn't seem to matter how rough it is. If you got a good captain behind the helm who knows they got to keep the throttle down just a little bit and keep that nose up, they always seem to fare well. We very rarely ever see these guys stuff the bow or do anything crazy, and the girls have spotted the camera. They're going to give us a nice little wave, but I'll tell you what, we're going to go ahead and give this round to the boats. I mean, even in the rough stuff right here, this boat really just chopped its way through. Nobody ever looked in any danger, and they're going to take an easy win here in the first round. Our second contestant to do battle with Boca today is going to show you what it's like coming through Boca doing something you probably shouldn't be doing. In fact, any inlet coming like this would be a terrible idea. Our guy is sitting here on the bow of this boat, and he really gets lucky he walks away with his teeth in this one. Here he's sitting up there, gets full airborne off this wave, and slams down, and really, this is just a horrible idea, and just for the safety factor, I've got to give them a loss on this round. And that's going to even things up at one apiece, but you know what? Here in the third round, we've got somebody coming in hot. Here we're going to see this pursuit start to work its way through Boca Inlet. It's always tough to tell how fast these boats are going, especially at distance, but my man is basically out there slaying Boca right now. He is coming through, throttles down, pounding his way through these waves, letting the boat do the work, and things look pretty solid. I mean, he almost gets full airborne right there, and this is a big, heavy boat. But these guys blast their way through the inlet, and things look pretty good. Even right here, they start to get a little squirrely for a moment, but with this much power and displacement behind them, they're easily able to gain control and will easily take a win for the boats here in the third round, giving the boats the early advantage here in our competition. And that'll take us to our fourth round, where not everybody seems to play by the rules. And we do have rules here on Boats vs. Holover, and the first rule is no kids in the bow without a life jacket on. And this crown line, unfortunately, is breaking the first rule, which is a guaranteed loss. Here we can see them coming through Boca, and it's a rough day. This is just not a good idea, and I don't want to give the boats an easy loss like this, so you know what? We're going to go ahead and give the boats a shot at redemption here. We're going to play somebody else in the fourth round, and we'll play my favorite game, Can They Hang On? Here this crew's rolling through Boca, and this guy doesn't look like he has much of a shot of hanging on right off the bat. Here he's already struggling, but as they come down through Boca, Boca knocks him down, says, take a seat right here, and these guys are down for the count, and the boats will still wind up taking a loss here in the fourth round. That'll take us into our fifth and final round, tied at two apiece. Who will take the win this week? Will it be the boats or Boca Inlet? It is a rough day down here at Boca, but the boats look like they're going to throw a ringer in here in the fifth round, as they're going to pull out a big Everglades with triple 300s on the back. This boat's got the displacement and the horsepower to go ahead and get its way into Boca Inlet unscathed. And right here, they look okay so far. The boat's fighting the waves as much as it can, but it's battling its way through, and it looks like they're likely going to make it into the inlet. We're not going to stuff the bow, and we're going to take a win for the boats in this episode. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Boats vs. Holover. If you did, be sure to check out our other channels. We have Wavy Boats, who gets all this great footage down at Boca Inlet and Holover Inlet. My channel, Broncos Guru, where we do some great comedy boating videos as well. And of course, Miami Boat Ramps, that focuses on all the hilarity that happens at the boat ramps around South Florida. And if you haven't already, go ahead and drop an anchor on the subscribe button here.